Hi everyone. Welcome to the first ever virtually streamed version of the 28th Annual Fashion Production Association Design Show.
We want to thank you for tuning in to see all of the incredible designs that the talented students created throughout the year.
My name is Taylor Burke.
And my name is Grace Nani. And we are the co-presidents of the Fashion Production Association.
This year has been a whirlwind of meetings, planning, and decision-making through an organization of over 100 members. Even after all of that, there's one thing we could have never seen coming.
The COVID-19 pandemic has forced us as an organization and a student body to look inwards to our Project Runway selves and truly make it work.
Our team has worked together over the last few weeks to find a new way to showcase our designers and show off the work of our production team to make this video come to life. At the start of this year, we were preparing to showcase 36 designers with over 80 garments on a live runway. Because of the pandemic, we are only able to showcase 11 designers creating 25 garments for our virtual show. We hope that while watching the show, you are able to see the passion and dedication these students have dedicated to FPA over the past year.
Now we would like to recognize our 2020 service learning charity, Dress for Success Columbus. Dress for Success is an incredible organization that strives to empower women to achieve economic independence by providing a network of support, professional attire, and the development tools to help women thrive in work and life. Our members were able to work with and build relationships with the women at the boutique.
A special thank you to Rhea Opiniano and Stephanie Campolo-Merkel for making this partnership possible. Please enjoy a few words from the Dress for Success community.
In 2012, I was actually at domestic violence shelters called Choices. They sent me there for interview soon in. I didn't know where to go. I was asking. A girl told me, take a bus, number two, and try to find your way. It was a beautiful lady who waved to me, her name Denise. She opened the door and she hugged me really tight, like she knew me or something. I needed that hug because I was in shelter by the time. I just was so happy. And everybody was telling me I was beautiful. You look so cute. Where are you from? And everybody was happy to see me there. When I was married, I never heard you're beautiful. I was wearing clothes, but I never felt special like I did with Dress for Success. And I didn't believe that was free for me. I was asking her again and again, and she was telling me, you don't have to worry about it. This is for free and this is for you. I said to my mind, do I have to go through all that mess for me to get here? Probably is a good thing that happened to me. All those clothing thing, it was just the beginning for me. My heart told me, just stick with these people. You are in the right spot.
And there are times when I know that I have been able to leave an impact on Rashida, and times where we've left our conversation where she has made a very big impact on me. She has worked so very hard to earn this moment, and she deserves it.
Rashida is a humble, loving, awesome woman. We just couldn't have been more proud of Rashida when she graduated from nursing school. So she had the Dress for Success cheering section at her graduation. She's a great mom. And you see Rashida with her daughter and her eyes just light up. And when she talks about what she wants to do in the future, it's not just about what she wants to do for her. It's because she wants her daughter to be proud of her.
I'm just happy that my daughter will be there. I don't want her to see me. I want everything to be for her. Dress for Success is my spot to fulfill me inside of my heart, where I can go and get hope, energy, strength to keep going. I came from my country with dreams. When you own your dreams, you know what you deserve as women. Plus, Dress for Success and its support, it's easy to go.
Now we would like to thank our advisors, Alex Sewer, Dr. Nancy Rudd, and Wendy Goldstein. You all have offered overwhelming support throughout this year, and we cannot be more grateful.
We are incredibly appreciative to work alongside such talented women who have been a part of the organization for 28 years. Dr. Nancy Rudd originally started this organization as a course within the Fashion and Retail Studies program at Ohio State. Now, 28 years later, we are able to offer students fashion production experience both in and out of the classroom. This year was special in that Alex Dewar became head advisor. Thank you, Dr. Rudd and Wendy, for assisting in this transition. It could not have been possible without you.
Our show this year is titled Conviction. Conviction is defined as a fixed or firm belief of being sure about something and having no doubts. We centered this theme around historical social movements or those that are currently happening today. We want to showcase these movements that have individually brought each of us a sense of meaning or purpose. Designers were asked to design garments based on what brought them conviction. Ultimately, it was a question we all had to ask ourselves. What is your conviction? We ask that you, too, think about this question as you watch the show.
We hope you enjoy the 28th annual FPA Design Show in its first ever virtual format. Never underestimate the power of fashion to communicate the true convictions in our hearts. Let's make it work.
My conviction is cultural revival.
Transparency.
Breaking the gender binary.
Individuality.
Removing the stigma.
Inclusivity.
I'm Jackie.
Hi, I'm Sydney.
Our conviction is free love, which not only is the freedom to explore your sexuality, but also the right to make every and all decisions regarding your body.
We believe issues like birth control and marriage concern the people involved, not the government.
Though this movement was born out of the 1960s and 70s, we believe it remains very relevant today.
We wanted to pay tribute to the movement's history by incorporating heavy and thick fabrics such as suede and denim, patchworking elements, and flare silhouettes. Enjoy!
Hi everyone, my name is Alyssa Rayburn, and my conviction is mental health, specifically how it can affect your emotions on a daily basis. I decided to name my collection The Butterfly Effect, which is defined by the phenomenon whereby a minute localized change in a complex system can have large effects elsewhere. For my collection this year, I decided to interview a few of my closest friends who I know battle various mental illnesses. I asked them to give me one word to describe how their illness makes them feel on a daily basis. The words I were given are trapped, guilty, powerless, and foggy. They all have their own stories, and I decided to tell them through a ready-to-wear collection. Throughout the collection, you will see accessories, symbols, and small touches that bring each look to life and empower the meaning behind the given word. This collection is very special to me, and I think it can have a powerful impact. I hope you enjoy the virtual show.
I'm Lexi Casper.
And my name is Taylor Guthrie.
And our collection is called Vote.org. 100 years ago, brave women fought to gain us the right to vote during the women's suffrage movement. But today, only a small portion of young adults who are eligible to vote do so.
We created our collection to raise awareness of this issue and to encourage young adults to vote. Because of the 2020 election coming up this fall, it is one of the only ways for our voices to be heard.
We hope you enjoy our collection and don't forget to register to vote. Thank you.
I'm Sydney Smith.
And I'm Charlene Mustfall.
And our collection is called Night Fever.
Our collection is a representation of the feminist movement, the LGBTQ plus community, and women of color.
Night Fever was inspired by the disco culture of the 1970s and the safe space that disco became for so many.
We channeled the disco stars of the era by using bright rainbow colors, dramatic silhouettes, and textured fabrics and materials.
Through our collection, we really hope to capture the creative, diverse, and inclusive space that was 1970s disco.
Thank you all so much for your support along the way, and we hope you enjoy the virtual show.
Hi, I'm Geetha, and I'm one of the individual designers for this year's virtual fashion show. My collection's name is Shakti, which is a Hindi word meaning strength in English. My conviction is women empowerment, women supporting other women, and men empowering women with fair treatment and respect in the workplace, school, and personal relationships. My designs give women a strong sense of herself so she can feel empowered to project that in any situation. Clothing can empower us to have confidence and accept nothing less than respect and equality. I've used bold colors and an Indo-Western fusion look throughout my designs. When I first began my collection, this is what I had created. Thank you.
Spencer Wayne Forum here shooting from my house in Upper Arlington. I just wanted to kind of talk to you guys about my collection, who I am as a designer. This collection is called Human v Nature. It's about the rise of CO2 emissions and the melting of icebergs. So there's a lot of contrast in this collection with color and materials. I wanted to kind of create something that was a tangible representation of this issue, kind of make something that's so beautiful that people can't help but understand what we're putting our planet through. So there's a lot of queer and camp influences that are inside of this. A lot of speed racer kind of vibes with like motorcycles, cars, that classic like blue, white, red color scheme mixed with a little bit of aqua. I really enjoyed making this collection for everyone to see, so I hope you guys enjoy.
I'm Taylor.
I'm Carissa Kuzmal, and our collection is called Fate of the Forest.
Our conviction is preserving the Amazon rainforest. 30 million acres of forest were lost in 2018, 3.2 million acres in Brazil alone.
Commercial activities like mining, ranching, and soy production are huge drivers for forest loss.
In addition to providing a habitat for animals and other plants, it is a critical tool in fighting climate change. The Amazon is a carbon sink, helping suck excess carbon emissions from the atmosphere and also providing 20% of the world's oxygen.
Without initiative, deforestation activities will continue to rise. Our collection is the representation of a forest fire's life cycle, starting with lush green life, introducing fire, and ending in ashes. Take a stand and join us in making a difference for our planet.
We hope you all enjoyed the show. Before we go, we'd like to thank those individuals who opted to donate 100% of their ticket purchase to Dress for Success Columbus. Because of you, we were able to donate $1,115 to the Dress for Success organization. Thank you for your generosity.
Additionally, we would like to thank our corporate sponsors.
Thank you to our feature sponsor, Excel Incorporated. Thank you to our select sponsors, Friends of Guatemala, La Flair Boutique, and Golden Giant. And thank you to our patron sponsors, RF Berger and Associates, and Britta Coonsley.
Because of you, we were able to raise $950 to support student designers and talented production members to bring their creative work to life. We thank you so much for your support.
We would also like to send a special thank you to a few outstanding members of our community. Each of these individuals has taken a special interest in FPA through mentorship and coaching opportunities. We would not be where we are today without each and every one of you. Thank you to Thomas McClure, founder of Columbus Fashion Week and the Columbus Fashion Council. Thank you to designer Corey Winborn of Winborn Designs and industry member Renard Green. Thank you, Michael Garrett, for donating your time to help us put this video together. Each of you have continued to inspire us in so many ways, and we cannot be more grateful for your support.
Now, please enjoy a few last words from our advisors and the 2020 executive team.
On behalf of the FPA advisors, thank you for participating and viewing our very first ever virtual design show. Without the support and encouragement of our students, family members, friends, and the local fashion and retail community, we would not be able to have pulled together such a successful design show, especially under such extraordinary circumstances. We're so proud of all the hard work and creativity that they have demonstrated throughout the entire year, and we are so thankful to have had the opportunity to teach and mentor them. Thank you so much, and we hope to see you again next year.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. I'm Stephanie Adams. I was director of marketing this year and I've been part of FPA for a couple years now. It's really been my passion project, what's gotten me through the years at OSU, and I made a lot of friends, and I hope that you enjoyed our show.
Hi, Jackie here. I just wanted to thank everyone for another great year at FPA. Sad it's my last one, but so grateful to have been part of this club. I joined not really knowing anything about design, and thanks to the advisors and my co-director of design, Sydney, and all the other members, I've grown so much, both in my technical skills as well as leadership ability, and I really can't thank everyone enough. So good luck next year, and I can't wait to see what the org does.
Hey guys, I just want to give a huge thanks to FPA for everything they've given me, from advisors to amazing students that I've worked with. It's been an incredible experience, and I can't wait for my senior year. Thanks so much.
FPA really means a lot to me. My freshman year, I remember coming to OSU as a business major. I was so confused, didn't know what I wanted to do. And I remember I switched over to fashion. FPA was the first club that I joined that was fashion related. And through that, I've just met so many amazing and inspiring people, friends, colleagues, advisors like you guys. You guys really push me to do better. You guys inspire me all the time with all the hard work and your creativity. And I just feel really blessed and really lucky to be a part of this organization and to even have been trusted with an exec spot. And I have learned so much throughout this whole year, and I'm really looking forward to next year for my last year. And I think as I grow older throughout my professional career, I will definitely always look back on FPA with very fond memories. And I attribute a lot of my professional growth and creative growth to FPA. So yeah, I love you guys. I love this organization, and I'm really grateful and proud of us.
Hi everyone, just wanted to say thank you so much for all the effort you put in this year. Though this is not the way we thought the show was going to play out, I am still very proud of each and every one of you and the effort you put into the show. And thank you so much for making this last year of FPA so special for me.
One of my favorite parts about FPA has always been getting to be a part of such a creative space every week. This year, I've been so surprised by the overwhelmingly positive response to our design team regarding our new virtual show format and how eager everybody's been to show their work as best they can regardless of the circumstances. Our design team continues to inspire me, and I'm so proud to be a part of it and so excited to see everybody's incredible work.
Hi guys, it's Sam. I was this year's executive production, and I just wanted to extend a quick thank you to everyone who worked on the show this year, whether that be our union event planners, our advisors, and to each and every one of our general members. I know that this took so much work, and I am so, so proud of the way we've been able to pull through, and I'm excited to see what energy we can bring to next year. So, thank you.
Thank you guys, we did it. We pulled off the virtual show, and I am so proud and thankful for all of you. This would not have been possible without you, the members of the Fashion Production Association, for always bringing constant passion, dedication, and hard work to the table. I want to thank the exec team for always problem solving, even through the most difficult times. I think you're all amazing. Thank you, Taylor, my co-president, for always just being there through it all and having an answer all the time. Thank you to my advisors. You are all the mentors that I needed throughout this process, and I am so grateful for each and every one of you. I am so excited, and I hope that you all enjoyed. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. Hope you enjoyed the virtual show. I just wanted to say thank you to FPA for giving me the best possible college experience. To my general members, I know this year didn't go quite as planned, but because of your passion and dedication for FPA, we were able to pull off the first ever virtual show. Please bring that same passion and dedication back next year. I know it's going to be a great year. To my exec team and my co-president, thank you for being the best team that I could have hoped to have led this year. You guys are the greatest friends, and you are such a strong group of students. I'm so proud to have been a part of it. To my advisors, thank you for supporting me and challenging me over the last 4 years. Because of you, I am the strong woman that I am today, and I am so happy to have been a part of this organization and to lead alongside of all of you this past year. I'm so sad to leave you all this year, but I'm so proud to leave knowing that you guys are going to be great and you're going to do great things in the future. I love you all. Thank you.